Okay, we're ready to paint today. We've got self-etching primer. This is something I've had to find at the auto parts store. Lowe's, Home Depot, Ace, True Value, none of those guys carry it. Everything is masked off that I don't want to paint, including the edge where we're going to put in the acrylic, because I want the acrylic glue to stick right to aluminum. But the rest of it, we're going to get most of the painting done before the acrylic goes in. And then once we put the acrylic in, we'll come back and get closer to the edge on that. So it's been sanded with a, I think I used 120 grit, I think. And that got off a lot of the scratches and weld spots. And then we came in, we washed it with a degreaser. And then we rinsed it with a hose down to get all the degreaser off. And let it air dry and made sure it's good and dry. Taped it in the meantime. And now we're ready to use the self-etching primer, which is all kinds of nasty chemicals. But basically it does probably a very similar thing to what you can get done with vinegar. And a good white vinegar will put a little bit of an etch on it too. But it's just one more stage of prepping the surface. The sanding also, the texture, the profile that it leaves in it, is going to help the paint stick. Because I've painted the bilge once with epoxy, and when it was done, you could just peel the epoxy off like plastic. So hopefully this will give us a good primer down for aluminum, and if it worked that well, I've got other aluminum things I'm going to be painting, so I'll let you know. We got a nice windy day, so everything's well ventilated, and it's got just a light gray pigment in it, so it'll take three coats to get everything coated nicely. If they put that light gray, that primer there, they're real thin, they say, and that's just so that you can know when you got three coats on and good coverage. Okay, there's the first of three coats on, and I think I'll have enough to finish it. Oh, I gotta get up there on the top a little more. But the reason we're painting this is for a couple of reasons. First off, this is where I learned to weld, so some of my welds up here are pretty lousy, and paint will help fill the pinholes. And secondly, light, this is a submarine, so light that enters from the viewports, you want to be absorbed and not reflected, because if it's reflected, you get a glare that will come off of the bottom viewports where it's darker out from them. Kind of like having the lights on inside of a house at night. You can't see out the windows. And that's the end of three coats. So that's the end of the can. So that's where we're gonna stop. And just a little bit left. Okay, so 2 hours to let this dry, and then color paint, which is gonna be darker gray.
There it is with two coats of sandable primer and then sanded with 220 grit paper lightly and then dusted out. And I'm not terribly impressed because there's a scratch already just from where I laid the control box. And you can see it came off the edge with sanding just lightly. So, we'll see. You know, that's a high spot in a weld that sanded down. So now I'm going to use a top coat on it. A flat black. Actually, it says high gloss. Not by the cap, but anyway, we're going to use a black as the top coat over the sanding primer, and it's the same brand. It's a duplicate color from, I'm picking all the paint up from O'Reilly's Auto Parts Store. They're the ones that had the etching primer, so that's where I got the rest of it. And we'll see what it does. I got a test sample that I'm working to, which doesn't have the etching primer on it, so I'm going to see if I will scratch this a little bit too and see if I had any benefit. Okay, here we go with the scratch test. I got a rock pick hammer, and I'm just going to let the weight of the hammer be the gauge here. I got a piece of aluminum, cleaned it with acetone. That's the primer. This is the top coat. Top coat with no primer under it. Top coat with primer under it. Primer only. The edge closest to the gasket here is roughened. You can see it over here where it's been sanded down with a grinder. That was before gluing on the gasket. So here we go. Just going to drag it across. Okay.
lifted the paint in a couple places. Do one right beside it. Not too bad on the primer. Actually, you know, there's a gouge running across the metal there. A little closer for you, see if it stays in focus. It's kind of neat, it always pulls loose in the same spot. But that's pretty good across the primer. All right, let's try it where it was textured or had a profile in it. Yeah, it's hard to say. Profile doesn't seem to help it any at all. I don't know, that was pretty clean. But you know what? Right there it's got primer and then top coat. And the only time it's really pulling loose paint is when it has this gouge mark that runs up through there. It's got a place to bite in and lift the paint. So too much profile and you got a problem. But other than that, I think I'm pretty satisfied that the primer is helping. Here's what the front looks like painted in black with the masking tape removed, so I can still glue the windows into fresh aluminum. And it looks pretty good. Had to go with black because they didn't have a top coat color in the dark gray, so it just turned out all black. But I think it'll look all right.